Hi everyone, it's Karen here. Welcome to another video from me. And today marks the start of a new creative challenge from Lavinia Stamps entitled Under the Sea. So I hope you'll join me as I show you how I created this little sparkly Under the Sea card. I did a video a couple of weeks ago, similar stamps, but here I'm showing you a different background technique. We've got different foliage and different stencils. I've also added in a few different fish. So, the card size that I'm using is 17.5 centimetres by 17.5 centimetres or 7-inch square. And it's from this pack of multifarious cardstock, which is 330 GSM from Lavinia Stamps. I'm using three stencils in the background here. I've got Elegance, I've got Stone, and I've got Flora. So those are my three stencils. The ink pads that I'm using, I'm stamping the fish in Twilight. It's a lovely midnight blue. I'm then using Warm Breeze and Verdant for the foliage and the bubbles. For the background, I'm using Distress Oxides, and I've got Cracked Pistachio, Salty Ocean, and Blueprint Sketch around the edge. And then I'm finishing it off with some liquid pearls and some stickles in bluey greeny colours. So we'll get started, and the first thing that we're going to do, I'm going to use my stamping platform to stamp the fish, because they're nice solid images and I want to make sure that I get that solid image on my card. So here we go, all neatly stamped up. As you saw, I used VersaFine Clear Twilight. I love it, it's an oil-based ink, and it means that it's going to take my washed background beautifully. So I used Flo, she's one fish on her own, and then Arlo, he also is on his own, and these two fish come in the fish set. So, Mummy's leading the way. These guys are in between, and Daddy's bringing up the rear. That was my thought on that one. So I'm going to take Cracked Pistachio first, and I'm going to put quite a bit down on my mat. So I was just twisting the ink pad there, spritzing it with a tiny bit of water, and then I've got my 1-inch wide brush. This is just, you know, any old paintbrush will do. I like the 1-inch because it just gives a nice width. I'm loading up my brush, picking up as much of that paint, if you like, as possible. And then I'm just going to sweep it gently in straight lines. Well, as straight as you can get when you're just doing it freehand like this. And I'm starting from one edge and drawing it across the card. And I'm going to keep this greeny colour towards the top of the card, and I'm going to put some blue down to the bottom. Now, it's okay if you've got some streaks in it. That's going to create some little extra texture in our background. So I'm going to wipe that off, but of course you could use that on another piece of card. And then I'm going to take Salty Ocean and do the same. I'm not cleaning my brush off in between because it's okay. I'm not going to dry this because it's very light and it's probably dry anyway. So again, creating the wash, smushing it around. And I'm going to start at the bottom here The reason I'm starting at the bottom is because it's going to be darker, and I'm not sure exactly how dark it's going to be. So if I start at the bottom, because I'm going to create, let me show you, I'm going to blend around the edge so I can hide it if it's too dark. So no definite line between where the green and the blue join. There we go. Lovely. Now I will clean off my brush. And I never leave my brushes in water, so I'm just drying it off. Ready for the next time. Wiping off my mat. And just in those few seconds whilst I'm talking, my background will dry. You do want to make sure that it's fully dry. Okay. Then we're going to do our stenciling. So I'm going to start first with Flora. And I'm going to put Flora down this side of the card, and I'm going to take my lovely new stencil brushes. If you haven't used these, they are super fun. They are really soft. Look at these bristles. They're just lovely and soft. I saw someone asking, do we need one for each colour? No, at the moment I've only got two, but I am probably going to have about five or six. So I'll have one for blues and greens because I use those colours a lot, but you could have those the same, one for purples, reds, yellowy, oranges. So that's what I'm going to do. And then to clean them off in between, I'll just use a piece of paper towel and go backwards and forwards. I tend not to smush it too much like that because I don't want the bristles to splay, but I love them. They are lovely. So we're going to take Flora Stencil, and we are going to take Salty Ocean. So we're going tone on tone, background with Salty Ocean, and I'm using Distress Oxide Salty Ocean. Loading up my stencil brush, and I just pull it backwards and forwards like that, making sure that it's got a nice lot of ink on it. I take off the first heavy pieces, and again, I'm going to start at the bottom, because then if I've gone too dark as I started, it's going to be hidden with my round the edge blending. And then I'm just going to play bringing this stencil all the way up around the side of this card. Round the edge, I've gone a bit heavier, and towards the middle, I'm making it a little bit softer. So you can see, not all parts where I'm laying the ink down is of the same depth. And that's because I want it to look as though it's sort of fading into the background here. Tiny bit in between them. There we go. Now, I don't want too much of an empty space in the middle here, so I'm just going to bring this very lightly. There we go. And then I'm going to take my green, my cracked pistachio, which again was what I had on the top, and do exactly the same. Load up my brush. Now, I don't want it to look like I've got the Flora stencil there and the Elegant stencil there. So the way we're going to make that look as though it blends together is I'm going to start over here with my green. You can see I'm not taping these stencils down. You could if you wanted to, but we're only using them for a few seconds. And you pretty much can hold them well in place. It also helps me flip it up so I can just have a little look as to what's happening underneath. Now, I want these two to join, so I'm going to bring this down here. And then I might just take a bit of the blue and just gently sweep it into this stencil so that they've merged together. Then I'm going to take my stone stencil. Now there are a couple in the range that are similar. There's a pebbles, but I like this one for bubbles. And I'm just going to lay it along the top, load up my brush with the cracked pistachio, and gently create some texture in the top part of the C. Now I am swirling it round, but ever so lightly, so it's only literally just touching the card. And again, I'm going to join up where I had my stencil. They're going to overlap a bit, and bring it down here. Again, in between the fish. There we go. So there's our background. And as I said, to clean off my brush, I'm just going to sweep it backwards and forwards a few times. Okay, now we're going to do our stamping. And for this, I'm going to use sea flower. And I'm going to use warm breeze in VersaFine Clair. A gentle tap, tap, tap. This is ever such a delicate stamp. So I'm just going to pop the first one there. Look at the detail on that stamp. You can see it there. Each of those tiny little pods individually. Now you're going to lay these at different heights. There we go, so that the pods look as though they are up and down at the bottom of the ocean. And then I'm going to take my sea algae stamp. There's a very similar one called Sea Tangle that's a lot larger, but this one I thought worked really well. I'm still going to stay with my warm breeze. And I'm going to pop the first one there. And then I'm going to leave a space, because I'm going to bring in a different colour. And again, just inking up and just having them at different heights. Now I'm just going to quickly clean off this stamp because I'm going to put a lighter colour in between. And I'm going to use Verdant for this. I love this colour and I think it lend itself beautifully to this scene. Now usually when I'm inking up my stamps, I take my stamp pad to my stamp. But when I'm doing multiple stamps like this, I will tap it. So you can see, I've done those all at different heights. And then I'm just going to pop a few in between that sea flower. And because the colour is as it is, it lends itself really well to that. I'm just going to put one more behind this one. There we go. But of course you can carry on playing as much as you like. Okay, now I'm going to take my blending sponge. Sorry. And I'm going to take Blueprint Sketch. And if you've watched me at all before, you will know how much I love Blueprint Sketch, because it just gives you such a deep colour for the bottom of the ocean. And I'm going to go all the way around the edge. So there we have it. Now you saw that I was using a piece of copy paper to protect the rest of the card, and that's so that some of my inky fingers didn't get over the rest of my stamping. So now what we're going to do is take some water from my spritzy bottle, a few sprays in my hand, and I'm going to give myself a hand. I'm just going to clap my hands together, tiny bit, and I'm going to clap my hands all over the edge of that blending that I've just done. What that's going to do is it's going to pick up some of the water off the distress oxides and give you even more bubbles around the edge. And then the very last thing we're going to do is I'm going to pick out the different... Oh no, that's not true. I'm going to do something else first. I'm going to do the bubbles. These are called sea bubbles. I'm using Warm Breeze here. And second generation. Actually, I'm going to put them up there like that. I'm using this piece of paper to mask off. This is a long stamp, which is great if you want to use the whole stamp, but because I only want to use pieces of it, I'm using this piece of paper to mask off the pieces that I don't want. Second generation, he's just going to have one bubble popping out of his mouth. Second generation. Up there. And then, second generation, we're going to create some bubbles coming up from the bottom of the sea. Because always at the bottom there's bubbles everywhere. And maybe bubbles there. There we go. I know there's no one here, but I'd like another set of bubbles somewhere there. That's it. So as the fish family swim this way, they're leaving behind them a load of bubbles. That's the little story anyway. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to create this texture, putting some glitter, some liquid pearls on each of the stamps. I'm going to start, if you're right-handed, I would start on this side of the page, the left side of the page, so that as you move across, you don't smudge it. If you're left-handed, obviously, you'll want to do it the other way. So here I'm using stickles, I'm using waterfall. The other liquid pearls that I'm using is mermaid, white opal, and baby blue. And so there we have it. All the glitter, all the liquid pearls over your lovely underwater scene. So thanks so much for joining me. Thanks for watching. I'd love to see what you make. Please tag me. Bye for now.